I don't support demoralizing government. Because security situation, if you look at this country, you can't trace it to one or two or three past government. It started somewhere. But the major foundation of insecurity is because of lack of good governance. The representative of the people, both the executive and the legislative arm of government, if hither to this moment we have laid a solidified foundation, we have done things that have direct bearing to the common man. Issue of basic social amenities were addressed, education, good hospital, people have access to affordable system of education and what have you. Definitely you will not see the people running on the street that tomorrow turns out to be Boko Haram or other elements in the society that they are not supposed to be. If Nigeria of today was Nigeria of Obasanjo's era, the issue of Odi massacre would have echoed more than the way it sounded at that time. But because of technological depreciation at that time, Nigerians were managed in a democracy as if it was a military regime. But the freedom and the expressions that the technological development have donated to Nigerian people, people talk. And every little deficiency of government is being echoed. I want to advise as press, we must make sure too that we organize some of those criticisms. Let them be geared towards stimulating government into action, not toward antagonizing the little effort that government is doing towards changing the life of the people of this country. Then the problem between the Police Service Commission and the police created a problem to Nigerians. Annually, police are expected to recruit 10,000 constables. But because there is a case in court, the recruitment stopped. And I now say, since there is a legal gap between the Police Service Commission Act as well as the operations of the Nigerian police itself, there is a need for us to clear all the ambiguity in terms of the functions of the police force and that of the Police Service Commission. So the bill came up, and the public hearing was meant to say whose responsibility is to recruit constables. Part of the adjustment in the Police Service Commission has to do with allocating specific responsibility to the Police Service Commission, as well as because of the so many cries of police brutality and abuse of fundamental human rights by the Nigerian police, there was a need, in my own point of view, to expand the representation in the commission so that civil society organizations and other strategic organs within the country should participate in issues of discipline of the Nigerian police, so that the cry of police brutality without any action by the Police Service Commission, if people have adequate representation in that board, it will be fine. So this is one of the bills. The other one is the National Institute of Police Studies. It's an establishment bill, because all over the country, including some African countries, foreign government donates funds as well as trainings. What is happening with the police and the brutality is as a result of lack of adequate training. Then if you don't have a legislation establishing an institution like National Institute of Police Studies, the foreign support in terms of training and retraining of middle and upper strata in the Nigerian police will never be possible. So these are the two bills.